हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन लेक्चर सीरीज ऑन मेजरमेंट एंड इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन और इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन एंड कंट्रोल मैकेनिकल फोर्थ सेमेस्टर। माइसल कपिल धामा, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, सेंट एंड्रयूज इंस्टीट्यूट टेक्नोलॉजी मैनेजमेंट, फारूक नगर, गुरुग्राम। सो स्टूडेंट, इन दिस लेक्चर 14 वी हैव डिस्कस इन लेक्चर 13 अबाउट द टेम्परेचर मेजरमेंट। सो दिस इज इन दिस लेक्चर 14 we will cover unit 3 for mechanical 4th semester and unit 4 for mechanical 6th semester. So the topic we cover in this lecture regarding the electrical temperature instrument, pyrometer, and some other methods of temperature measurements. So student, it is the resistance thermometer, first topic we have, and it is also called as RTD. Very important for the short note point of view. So they are used to measure the temperature by correlating the resistance of the RTD element with temperature. So the RTD element is made from a pure material, typically platinum, nickel or copper. So material has a predictable change in the resistance as the temperature changes, and it is this predictable change that is used to determine temperature. The student, the element are pretty fragile, and therefore they are kept inside a set probe. Now these RTD sensing elements constructed of platinum, copper and nickel having a repeatable resistance versus temperature relationship R versus T, as you know, and operating temperature range. So R versus T relationship defined as the amount of resistance change of the sensor per degree of the temperature change. So we have platinum, that is noble metal, having the most stable resistance temperature relationship over the largest temperature range, making it the best element for RTD with a very high repeatability over the range of -272.5°C to 961.78°C. So because platinum is very chemical inert, and nickel has limited range as over 572°F, nearly about 300°C, and relationship tend to become non-linear. Copper though has very linear relationships towards the R versus T, but it oxidizes at moderate temperature and cannot be used over 300°F. Okay students, but this is very important. Now, RTD use electrical resistance as a function of temperature change and require a power source to operate. The resistance value varies nearly linear with temperature flowing. Wendt's equation, RT is equal to R naught equal to 1 plus AT plus BT square plus CT cube T minus 100, and range is -200°C, say T chota hai aur bada chota rahega 0°C. We have certain equations depending upon the suitability of the requirement. Again, the significant characteristics of metal used as resistive element is the linear approximation of the resistance versus temperature relationship between 0 and 100°C. So the temperature coefficient of the resistance is called alpha, and this equation alpha is defined in its unit ohms per degree Celsius centigrade. And relation, students, as you know, is defined with the help of this formula. So R100 is equal to resistance of element at 100°C, R naught equal to resistance at 0°C. Pure platinum has an alpha of 0.003925 ohm per degree Celsius in the range 0 to 100°C range, and used for the construction of laboratory grade RTD. Okay. So this is the construction what we discuss in the resistance thermometer, students. So these elements nearly always require insulated lead attached, and at temperature below 250°, PVC, silicon, rubber or PTFE insulators are used. Above this, glass fiber or ceramic are used. Okay, the measuring points and usually most of the leads require a housing or protective sleeve. So often made of metal alloy, which is chemically inert to the process being monitored. तो स्टूडेंट, जैसे कि आप देख रहे हैं यहाँ पे रेजिस्टेंस टेम्परेचर है कनेक्शन टू द लीड्स, कनेक्शन लीड्स हमने ये रखी हैं दो, एंड शीट हमने अप्लाई रखा है इंसुलेशन के लिए, इंसुलेटर हमने प्रोवाइड किया हुआ है। तो ये कंस्ट्रक्शन है रेजिस्टेंस थर्मामीटर का। अगर हम वायरिंग कॉन्फ़िगरेशन के बारे में बात करें स्टूडेंट, जैसे कि आप देख रहे हैं कि व्हीटस्टोन रिंग प्रिंसिपल प्ले वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल। सो टू वायर कन्फिग्रेशन में जैसे कि आप देख रहे हैं कि जो फोर्थ हमारा जो आर्म है उसमें हमने रेजिस्टेंस एलिमेंट लगाया हुआ है फॉर द मेजरमेंट ऑफ द टेम्परेचर. सो सिंपलेस्ट रेजिस्टेंस थर्मोमीटर कन्फिग्रेशन यूजेस टू वायर्स. इट इज़ ओनली यूज व्हेन हाई एक्यूरेसी इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड. यू वांट टू कैलकुलेट द टेम्परेचर एट अप्रॉक्सीमेट रेंज. So as a temp resistance of the constructing connecting wires is added to that of the sensor, leading to errors of measurement. So this configuration allows use of 100 meters of cable. This applies equally to the balance bridge and fixing bridge system. तो आप जैसे कि पता है कि जब हम ब्रिज और ब्रिज को बैलेंस करते हैं तो हमारा जो फोर आर्म नेटवर्क है उसमें हम अपने गैल्वेनोमीटर के अक्रॉस देख लेते हैं कि नल डिफ्लेक्शन हमारा अचीव हो गया, जिससे कि हम देखते हैं कि ब्रिज हमारा बैलेंस कंडीशन में पहुँच गया. And that in that way we were able to calculate the unknown parameter. If we talk about the three wire configuration student in the similar construction, then in order to minimize the effects of the lead resistances, a three wire configuration can be used. Using this method, the two lead of the sensor are not on adjoining arms, and there is a lead resistance in each arm of the bridge so that the resistance is cancelled out, so as length two lead resistance are accurately the same value. Okay, and configuration is about 600 meter. उसमें 200 वाले में जो two wire configuration उसमें 100 meter का cable लगता है, यहाँ 600 meter का cable लग रहा है. और जैसा कि आप देख रहे हैं स्टूडेंट, if wire A and B are perfectly matched in length, their impedance effect will cancel because each is in the opposite leg of the bridge. So the third wire C acts as a sense lead and carries a very small amount of current. So this is the generalized block diagram. In the left side and right side it is a internal circuitry. If we talk about the four wire configuration student, the four wire resistance configuration increasing the accuracy of the measurement of the resistance. Four terminal sensing element voltage drop in the measuring leads as a contribution to error. So to increase the accuracy further, any residual thermoelectric voltages generated by different wires are screwed connections are eliminated by reversal of the direction of the 1 milliampere current, and this lead to the digital voltmeter reading. So thermoelectric voltage will be produced in one direction only. By averaging the reverse measurement, the thermoelectric voltages error voltage are cancelled out. So this is the diagram you see where we use the four wire configuration. Now if we talk about the calibration student, then two common calibration methods are fixed point method and the comparison methods are used in the resistance thermometer. So in fixed point calibration used for the higher accuracy calibrations uses a triple point, freezing point or melting point of a pure substance such as water, zinc, tin, argon to generate a known and repeatable temperature. The fixed points calibration point extremely accurate calibrations within the range of plus minus 0.01 degree. So आप देख रहे हैं कि इसमें जो accuracy calibration का level है वो बहुत अच्छा है. तो common fixed point calibration method for industrial grade probes is the ice bar. The equipment is inexpensive, easy to use and can accommodate several sensors at once. So the ice point is designed as a secondary standard because it is accuracy is 0.005 degree Celsius. Okay. And whereas if we talk about the comparison calibrations that is commonly used with the secondary standard platinum resistance thermometers and industrial RTDs, the thermometers being calibrated are compared to calibrated thermometers by means of bath. Whose temperature is uniformly stable. So unlike fixed point calibration, comparison method can be made at temperature between minus 100 degrees Celsius to 500 degrees Celsius. So this method might be more cost effective since several sensors can be calibrated simultaneously with automated equipment. So these electrically heated and well stirred baths are silicon oils and molten salts as the medium for the various calibration temperatures. The elements types in the resistance temperature students are thin film, wire wound and coil elements. Okay, there are three main categories of RTD sensors which are thin film, wire wound and coil elements. Carbon resistors are used as ultra low temperatures which has range minus 173 degrees Celsius to minus 273 degrees Celsius. So carbon resistors has wide variety and available and very inexpensive because the most reliable at extreme low temperature do not suffer hysteresis and strain cause effects. Very important. So strain free elements use a wire coil minimally spotted within a sealed housing filled with inert gas. These sensors are used up to 961.78 degrees Celsius, very high, nearly approximate. आप देख सकते हैं कि 1000 Hz तक ये 1000 degrees Celsius तक चला गया है. तो दे कंसिस्ट ऑफ प्लेटिनम वायर लूजली कॉइल्ड ओवर ए सपोर्ट स्ट्रक्चर टू प्रोवाइड फ्री एक्सपेंशन एंड कॉन्ट्रैक्शन विद टेम्परेचर. सो वाइब्रेशन एंड शॉक्स पे ये सेंसिटिव होता है. ओके तो ये जैसे कि आप देख रहे हैं कि एलिमेंट एम द थिन एलिमेंट हैव सेंसिंग एलिमेंट दैट इज फॉर्म्ड बाय डिपॉजिटिंग अ वेरी थिन लेयर ऑफ रेजिस्टिव मटेरियल नॉर्मली प्लेटिनियम ऑन ए सिरेमिक सबस्ट्रेट कोट विद ए एपॉक्सी ऑफ ग्लास एक्टिंग एज स्टीम रिलीफ. सो दीज आर सम एलिमेंट्स विच वी यूज इन द रेजिस्टेंस टाइप थर्मोमीटर. दिस इज अ वायर बाउंड एलिमेंट एंड दिस इज द कॉइल एलिमेंट. वट आर द फीचर्स वट वी ऑब्जर्व इन द रेजिस्टेंस थर्मोमीटर स्टूडेंट. इट इज़ अ एडवांटेज हाई एक्यूरेसी वाइड टेम्परेचर रेंज नॉर्मली बिटवीन -200 degrees Celsius टू 650 degrees Celsius. स्मॉलर साइज एंड फास्टिंग रिस्पॉन्स गुड रिपीटेबिलिटी स्टेबल एंड एक्यूरेट परफॉर्मेंस फॉर मेनी ईयर्स. सो टेम्परेचर कंपनसेशन इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड विच इज अ ग्रेट एडवांटेज. ओके डिसएडवांटेज ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस थर्मोमीटर इज हायर कॉस्ट. बेस सर्किट एंड पावर सप्लाई आर नीडेड. हीटिंग और रेजिस्टेंस एलिमेंट एंड करंट थ्रू ब्रिजेस सर्किट लीड टू इनएक्यूरेसी. मैकेनिकल अब्यूज इंड्यूस बिकॉज ऑफ वाइब्रेशंस. तो लार्ज बल्ब साइज देन थर्मोकपल स्लो रिस्पॉन्स टाइम एंड थर्मिस्टर्स. इफ यू टॉक अबाउट सम एरर सोर्सेस तो जैसे कि आप देख रहे हैं कि इंसुलेशन रेजिस्टेंस स्टेबिलिटी रिपीटेबिलिटी हिस्टेरेसिस स्टीम कनेक्शन कंडक्शन कैलिब्रेशन लीड वायर. सो दीज आर सम एरर्स व्हिच वी शुड कीप इन माइंड. इफ वी कंपेयर द आरटीडी वर्सेस थर्मोकपल सो देर आर सम पॉइंट्स व्हिच वी कंपेयर द आरटीडी रेजिस्टेंस टेम्परेचर डिवाइस विद रिस्पेक्ट टू थर्मोकपल्स दैट इज टेम्परेचर. If process temperature if we talk about that if we compare the RTD versus thermocouples on various points, so then first point is temperature. If the process temperature are between -200 to 500 degrees Celsius, then industrial RTD is very preferred option over the thermocouple. But the thermocouple has a range of -180 to 2320 degrees Celsius, which is a very high range. So for temperature above 500 degrees Celsius, they are only contact temperature measurement device. If we talk about the response time student, if the process requires a very fast response to temperature changes, the fraction of second as opposed to second, then a thermocouple is best choice. Okay, if you want the fast operation or fast response time, then you can use thermocouple over an RTD. Okay, and if size, a standard RTD sheet is 3.175 to 6.35 millimeter in diameter, jabki thermocouple ka jo hai 1.6 aapka millimeter hai. To ye size aur response time ke mamle mein thermocouple jo hai RTD se best hai. एक्यूरेसी की बात करें स्टूडेंट और एक्यूरेसी और स्टेबिलिटी रिक्वायरमेंट्स की, तो इफ ए टॉलरेंस ऑफ 2 degrees Celsius एक्सेप्टेबल देन हाईएस्ट लेवल ऑफ रिपीटेबिलिटी इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड. तो थर्मोकपल विल सर्व. आरटीडी आर कैपेबल ऑफ हायर एक्यूरेसी एंड कैन मेंटेन स्टेबिलिटी फॉर मेनी ईयर्स व्हाइल थर्मोकपल्स कैन ड्रिफ्ट विद इन द फर्स्ट फ्यू आवर्स ऑफ यूज. दिस इज द सर्टेन डिसएडवांटेज यू कैन सी द इन द थर्मोकपल ओवर द आरटीडी वेयर द ड्रिफ्ट प्रॉब्लम इज अकर इन द थर्मोकपल्स. Next we have the thermocouple student. The thermocouple consists of two wire legs, which is based on, as you see, the thermocouple is based on seepage effect, and it consists of two wire legs made from different metals. The wire legs are welded together at one end, creating a junction. This junction is where the temperature is measured. Okay, when a junction experiences a change in temperature, voltage is created. This is a simple effect and called as seepage effect. The voltage can then be interpreted using thermocouple reference tables to calculate the temperature. There are many type of thermocouples, each with its own unique characteristic in terms of temperature range, durability, vibration resistance, capital resistance and application of compatibility. So J, K, T and E, base metal thermocouples, ye most common thermocouples hain jo hum use karte hain. type R, S and B thermocouples are noble metals thermocouples which are used in higher temperature applications. So thermocouples are self-powered and require no external form of excitation. So these are active transducers. Thermocouple do not actually measure an absolute temperature, they only measure the temperature difference between the two points, commonly known as cold and hot junctions. So this is the working principle. As you see, the hot junction and the cold junction, a metal is provided, a metal B is also provided, which created a junction. So Thomas Johnson John Seebeck discovered that when any conductor is subjected to a thermal gradient, it generates a voltage. This is now the thermoelectric effect or Seebeck effect. Any attempt to measure this voltage may necessarily involve connecting another conductor to hot end. An additional conductor experiences the same temperature gradient and also develops a voltage which is normally opposite the original. This is the principle, student, as you know, the Seebeck effect, that energetic electrons at the hot end and diffuse towards the cold end, pushing less energetic electrons along the with them, resulting in a higher static potential at the hot end related to the cold end. The larger the temperature gradient, the larger is the potential difference. EAF is equal to minus S delta T. The classical configurations to make thermal effect measurable to different metal conductors are used. Okay, so the hot junction assured that the potential at point matches into metals immersing two different end junctions, ice, water and slurry, assured that the temperature gradients are the same across the both the material initially. Okay, this is the cold junction compensation student. Do require stable voltage reference in some form of ice point or a cold junction compensation. Since the thermocouple measures some temperature differentially, the cold junction temperature must be known in order to determine the actual temperature measured at hot junction. So output voltage of the thermocouple must also be compensated to account for the voltage created by non-zero cold junction temperature, and this process is known as cold junction temperature. We have some advantages and disadvantages. This is capable of being used to directly measure a temperature up to 2600 degrees Celsius, very high temperature, maybe brought into direct contact with a material being measured, high resolution without being reliable. Disadvantage, that is a non-linear nature, complex operation, two measurement requirement, calibration requirement may be used. There are some various types, as you see in the classification JKT, NB, RSME, GNB. These are the types. These are based on various types, जैसा कि आप देख रहे हैं कि JK, TE, RB, SMN. और मटेरियल का जो कॉम्बिनेशन है उनकी रेंज भी दे रखी है, एक्यूरेसी और रिमार्केबल इनके दे रखा है कि कौन किस लेवल पर कहाँ यूजफुल है. नाउ आरटीडी थर्मोकपल एंड थर्मिस्टर में आप देख रहे हैं स्टूडेंट, तो ये एक्यूरेसी, लिनियरिटी और सेंसिटिविटी कॉस्ट के रिस्पेक्ट में आपकी बात की गई है, जो एक टेबल को टेबल की फॉर्म समझ सकते हैं. ओके, नाउ वी टॉक अबाउट थर्मिस्टर स्टूडेंट. We discuss the RTD, we discuss the thermocouple, and we discuss the thermistor, and these three are most important in university examinations. So thermistors are thermally sensitive resistors whose prime function is to exhibit a large predictable and precise change in electrical resistance when subject to a corresponding change in the body temperature. So these are semiconductors made from a specific mixture of pure oxide of nickel, manganese, copper, cobalt, iron, magnesium, titanium and other metals at 982 degrees Celsius centigrade. Okay, so it has a negative temperature coefficient, or when subjected to an increase in body temperature, positive temperature coefficient. Okay, so this is the graph we observed in the RTD, thermistor and thermocouple. So this is the symbol of thermistor and various types of classifications we discuss. Now it has the some principles, student. Stein-Hardt and Hardt equation gives the reciprocal of absolute temperature as a function of resistance of the thermistor. Using the Stein-Hardt equation, we calculate the temperature of the thermistor equation, that is 1 by T is equal to A plus B log 1 of R plus C log on of R ka whole cube. Okay. So the resistance value of the thermistor is given by the this equation student. जैसे कि आप यहाँ देख रहे हैं, ये जनरलाइज इक्वेशन है और ये रेजिस्टेंस की इक्वेशन है, और केल्विन में रिप्रेजेंट किया. बीटा इज द वैल्यू द स्पेसिफाइड वैल्यू ऑफ थर्मिस्टर टेम्परेचर अंडर मेजरमेंट एंड रेफरेंस टेम्परेचर. ओके, द प्रिंसिपल इन्वॉल्व्ड इज टू मेजर द टेम्परेचर विद द थर्मिस्टर. इट इज प्लेस इन द मेजरिंग एनवायरमेंट एंड एज टेम्परेचर इंक्रीजेज द रेजिस्टेंस डिक्रीजेस. ओके, एंड वाइस वर्सा. So thermistor is placed in one leg of the Wheatstone circuit and balance condition with no change of temperature, the meter indicates zero. ये simply जो है Wheatstone bridge के ऊपर principle पर काम करता है. Okay. So as you see in the bridge circuit, the three resistors are connected constant RA, RB and RC, while the resistance sensor RS varies depending upon some physical variable like temperature, light level, etc. That where thermistor can be used. Okay. तो थर्मिस्टर कैन बी प्लेस एनीवेयर इन द ब्रिज वेयर विद थ्री कॉन्स्टेंट रेजिस्टर, बट डिफरेंट प्लेसमेंट्स कैन प्रोड्यूस डिफरेंट बिहेवियर इन द ब्रिज. फॉर एग्जांपल, डिफरेंट प्लेसमेंट्स माइट कॉज आउटपुट वोल्टेज टू गो डिफरेंट डायरेक्शन एज द टेम्परेचर चेंजेस. ओके, सो वी हैव थ्री कॉन्फ़िगरेशन, दैट इज टू वायर, थ्री वायर एंड फोर वायर कॉन्फ़िगरेशन स्टूडेंट्स. तो व्हेन देयर आर मोर देन टू वायर्स, द एडिशनल वायर्स आर सोली यूज्ड फॉर द कनेक्टिंग टू द एक्साइटिंग सोर्स. A three or four wire connection method place leads on a high impedance path through the measurement device, effectively attenuating errors caused by the lead wire. So student, these are the three, four and two wire connections of thermistor configuration. We have some advantage and disadvantage also, and thermistor offer better accuracy in comparison to RTD and thermocouple. Unlike RTD and thermocouple, they are very high sensitive, smaller in size as compared to thermocouple. Thermistor provide faster time response than RTD, offer higher stability, build indubitability. They are very reliable and convenient to use. Unlike thermocouple, which provide millivolt output, use of thermistor results in reasonable output voltage. So particularly low cost and easily adaptable temperature sensors. Disadvantage is highly non-linear. क्योंकि आप जैसे कि देख रहे हैं ग्राफ में हमारे को कुछ इस तरीके से उसका रिस्पॉन्स जबकि दिखेगा, जबकि जो थर्मोकपल का वो है इस तरीके से दिखेगा और RTD का कुछ इस तरीके दिखेगा. ओके, तो लिमिटेड टेम्परेचर रेंजेस. इफ यू टॉक अबाउट अ थर्मोपाइल स्टूडेंट, इट इज इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिवाइस डेट कन्वर्ट थर्मल एनर्जी इन टू इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी. इट इज कम्पोज ऑफ सेवरल थर्मोकपल्स कनेक्टेड यूजली इन सीरीज और लेस कॉमन इन पैरल. ओके, तो थर्मोपाइल डू नॉट रिस्पॉन्स टू एब्सोल्यूट टेम्परेचर बट जनरेट्स एन आउटपुट वोल्टेज प्रोपोर्शनल टू लोकल टेम्परेचर डिफरेंसेज और टेम्परेचर ग्रेडियंट. सो आउटपुट ऑफ थर्मोपाइल इज यूजली इन द रेंज ऑफ टेंस टू hundreds of millivolts. So output voltage of thermopiles n times a single thermocouple if n thermocouples are connected in the circuit. So this is the generalized diagram. Now student, if we talk about the pyrometer, very important in the temperature measurement. The pyrometer comes from the Greek word means fire and measurement. A pyrometer is a type of remote sensing thermometer used to measure the temperature of a surface, and it is a device that from a distance determines the temperature of a surface from the spectrum of thermal radiation it emits, a process known as pyrometry and sometimes radiometry. What the working principle involved in pyrometer is, a modern pyrometer has an optical system and a detector. Okay, so there is an involvement of optical concept. An optical system focuses the thermal radiation and onto the detector. The output signal of the detector temperature is related to the thermal radiation of the irradiance J star of the target objecting through the Stefan-Boltzmann law. The constant of the proportionality sigma called as the Stefan-Boltzmann constant and sensitivity epsilon of the objective. So this is the relation observe in the pyrometry. Now the output is used to infer the object's temperature from a distance with no need for the pyrometer to be used in thermal contact with the object, and it is a technique for determining a body temperature by measuring its electromagnetic radiation. If you talk about the optical pyrometer student, a bright comparison is made to measure the temperature. As a measure of the reference temperature, a color change with the growth in the temperature is taken. So this type of device compares the brightness produced by the radiation of the object whose temperature is to be measured with that of the reference temperature. The reference temperature is produced by the lamp whose brightness can be adjusted till its intensity becomes equal to the brightness of the source object. So for an object, its light intensity always depend upon temperature of the object, whatever may be its wavelength. So it is depending on the wavelength of the light. So after adjusting the temperature, student, the current passing through it is measured using a multimeter, as its value will be proportional to the temperature of the source when calibrated. It is a principle. What the principle we observe, that is, the radiation from the source is emitted and the optical objective lens capture it. Lens जो आपका है वो help करेगा focus thermal radiation को on the reference bulb. The observer watches the process through the eye piece and correct it in such a manner that the reference lab filament has a sharp focus and filaments is superimposed on the temperature source image. Okay. The observer start changing the rheostat value and current is in the reference lamp changes. This in turn changes its intensity, and this change in current can be observed in the three different ways. That is why the filaments is dark, that is cooler than temperature source, the filament is bright, that is hotter than the temperature source, and filament disappears. So thus there is an equal brightness between the filament and temperature source. At this time the current that flows in the reference lamp is measured. As its value is a measure of the temperature of the radiated light in the temperature source when calibrated. So this is the diagram we are talking about, the student, this circuitry, okay. And this is the optical pyrometer temperature measurement 1, 2 and 3. Filament is dark. So one is considered, filament is bright. Second is considered, filament is disappeared. तो आप देख रहे हैं ये तीन conditions में हमारा यहाँ पे observe हो जाएगा. We have certain advantages and disadvantages in optical pyrometry, student. That is, simple assembling of the device enables easy use. High accuracy with plus minus 5 degree Celsius. There is no need of any direct body contact between the optical pyrometer and object. As long as the size of the object whose temperature is to be measured fits with the size of the optical parameter, the distance between the both of them is not at all problem. So the device can be used for remote sensing, and this device cannot not only be used to measure the temperature but also can use to see the heat produced by the object per source. Okay. So this is the advantage. And if we talk about limitations, the device is not useful for obtaining continuous value of temperature at small intervals. So as a temperature measurement is based on the light intensity, the device can be used only in the application within the minimum temperature of 700 degrees Celsius. If we talk about the radiation pyrometer, the main theory behind this type of parameter is that temperature is measured through the naturally emitted heat radiation by the body. So this heat is known to be function of its temperature. According to the application of the device, the way in which the heat is measured can be summarized into two categories. That is total radiation pyrometry, and second one is selective radiation pyrometry. So in this method, the total heat emitted from the hot source is measured at all wavelengths. That is the total radiation pyrometry. In selective radiation pyrometry, in this method, the heat radiation from the hot source is measured at a given wavelength. So this is the basic difference between the total radiation and selective radiation parametry. So the principle involved is the radiation parameter has an optical system including a lens, a mirror and adjustable eye. The heat energy emitted from the hot body is passed on to the optical lens, which collects it and it focused on the detector with the help of mirror and eyepiece arrangement. The detector may be thermistor, resistance, temperature, thermocouple and photo multiplier tubes. Now the heat energy is converted to its corresponding electrical signal by the detector and it's sent to the output temperature display device. So this is the classification we discussed, the radiation pyrometry, student, classification that is based on the fixed focus type radiation pyrometry and variable focus type radiation pyrometry. So in fixed focus type radiation pyrometry, it is mainly consists of a long tube. A concave mirror is placed at the end of the tube as shown. We discuss in next figure. A sensitive thermocouple is also placed in front of the concave mirror in such a way, such a distance that heat radiation which enters the tube through narrow aperture at the front end of the tube is reflected by the concave mirror. is focused on the hot junction of the thermocouple. So student, due to this fixed concave mirror, the radiation is always focused on the thermocouple irrespective of the distance between the hot and the instrument. So this is the reason why the instrument is called as fixed focus type radiation parameter. तो ई एम एफ जो जनरेट होगी थर्मोकपल में वो मेजर्ड होगी विद द हेल्प ऑफ गैलोमीटर और मल्टी वोल्ट मीटर एंड दिस कैन बी डायरेक्टली कैलिब्रेटेड विद द टेम्परेचर टू गेट टेम्परेचर रीडिंग रीडली. तो दिस इज द डायग्राम वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट इन द सच टाइप ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन. इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द वेरिएबल फोकस्ड टाइप रेडिएशन पायरोमेट्री स्टूडेंट लाइक फिक्स्ड उसकी तरह फिक्स फोकस रेडिएशन पैरामीटर की तरह यहाँ पे क्या होगा पोजीशन ऑफ कनकेव मिरर कैन बी एडजस्टेड बाय एडजस्टिंग द नॉब अटैच टू द इंस्ट्रूमेंट. तो वहाँ पे आपका कनकेव मिरर जो है फिक्स्ड है यहाँ पे आप उसको नॉब के हिसाब से उसको स्लाइड डाउन कर सकते हो. ड्यू टू दिस एडजस्टेबल कनकेव मिरर द इंस्ट्रूमेंट इज नोन एज वेरिएबल फोकस रेडिएशन पैरामीटर. द कनकेव मिरर इज मेड ऑफ हाईली पॉलिश्ड स्टील. ओके the heat rays from the targeted hot object are first received by the concave mirror then are reflected on the blackened thermo junction consisting of very small copper or silver disc due to the which the wire forming the junctions are soldered. The visible image of the hot body can be seen on the small metallic disc attached to thermocouple junction through the eyepiece and central hole of the main concave mirror. The student, the position of the main concave mirror is adjusted until the focus coincides with the smaller metallic disc attached to the thermocouple junction. So the heating of the thermocouple junction due to this thermal image on the small metal disc produces an electric motor force. And the temperature of the object can be measured by measuring this thermally generated EMF by sensitive galvanometer or multimeter. So this is the arrangement we ऑब्जर्व इन द वेरिएबल टाइप एंड फिक्स टाइप. थोड़ा सा वो सिंपल है, ये थोड़ा कॉम्प्लिकेटेड है. तो वी हैव सम एडवांटेजेस एंड लिमिटेशन इन रेडिएशन पैरामीट्री. तो वेरिएशन वेरी हाई टेम्परेचर मेजरमेंट विदाउट डायरेक्ट कॉन्टेक्ट सुटेबल फॉर हाई टेम्परेचर मेजरमेंट कैन मेजर टेम्परेचर ऑफ वेरी स्मॉल वेरी डिस्टिंक्ट एंड वेरी फार ऑब्जेक्ट्स. इट कैन बी यूज टू मेजर ऑल टेम्परेचर वेवलेंथ बिटवीन 0.7 माइक्रोन्स एंड 20 माइक्रोन्स. दे हैव हाई आउटपुट एंड कम टू at moderate cost. Limitation of radiation parameter, the scale is non-linear, error in measurement possible due to, these are the limitations to it. Error in measurement possible due to the presence of intervening gases or vapors. MSCVC of target materials affects the measurement. Okay students, we have other methods of temperature measurement which are not in our case, but we should understand, categorize under the pyrometry, that is quartz thermometer, solid state temperature sensor and fiber optic temperature measurement system, ultrasonic thermometers. So this is all about the measurement of temperature, classification, their types, their laws, which we discuss in the previous lecture and this current lecture. I hope you students aapko samajh mein aaya hoga. To aane wale lectures mein aur topic ko discussion karenge. To is lecture mein itna hi. Tab tak ke liye thank you.